गुड डे। आई विल डिस्कस टुडे जॉब शेड्यूलिंग व्हेन सेवरल जॉब बट ए सिंगल मशीन इज देयर, सो हाउ यू विल शेड्यूल ए जॉब फॉर ऑप्टिमाइज योर टाइम एंड इंक्रीज योर कस्टमर सेटिस्फेक्शन। वेरी सिंपल एग्जाम्पल एंड यू विल understand the how you will schedule the job for this type of problem. There have various rules is there for in this cases when job is several but your machine is single. So these are the rules is a minimum process time method. This is also known as a shortest operation type method. Under this rule, job with the shortest process time is first scheduled, followed by the next lowest process time, so on. And other side, you can schedule job by due date method, DD method. In this method, the job with earliest due date is done first. And another process, first come, first serve method. In this method, job are scheduled in the order in which they are received by the company. Lowest process time method. This method is just reverse of MINPRT method, as job with longest process time method is attended first. Your this is opposite method. And another is dynamic slack and remaining operation, minimum slack per operation method. I will show you how to calculate and how to work. These are the method. In this method, first dynamic slack is computed. In this difference between the time and processing time, just processing time and difference due time. In this, the result is divided by remaining operation time, RO, unless specified is by assume as 1. If specified, then okay, otherwise assume 1. Final schedule of job under this method is done as per the ranking. The first which one is ranked is first job. So let's start with a simple example. This is the example for job WXYZ need to be done on same work center. Their process time and due date are given below. Sequence of the job by different method. X job process time is 5 and you have to complete and hand over to your customer within 12 days. X 6 days is for process time, you have to hand over within 18 days. Y job is 7 process time, you have to hand over by 21 days. Z 10 days, you have to hand over by 14 days. So with this example, I will explain all process we have already discussed. For first process is the minimum process time method. You see, it is already sequenced as per minimum process time 5, 6, 7, 10. So minimum process time method, you have to W is done first since it is least time process. So next X is done after W. So it will take 11 days in just less than 18. So there have no lateness. Next Y total days require 11 plus 7 is equal to 18, but you have to hand over in your mention before 21 days, so they are also no late. Next job Z total days 5 plus 6 plus 7 plus 10. After completing these days only, because these days already involve Y, X, W, X, Y job, after then only it will start Z and it will take 10 days. So after 28 days only Z you can complete. So, but you have to hand over C within 14 days. So there have some late. So how much, how many days late? J is 14 days late. So this is the MINPRT method, and I will explain the DD method. DD method is due date method. Due date method is the, here is due date. So you have to arrange your job less due date 12, 14, 18 and 21. Accordingly, you have to start first job is equal to 5. So Z, how many days you will take is after 5 is 10 days, 15 days. Accordingly, X 15 plus process time 6 days, 21 days. Accordingly, 15 days. So X, Y, Z, 28 days. So cumulative or total is your flow time is 5, 15, 21 and 28, 69 days. Average completion time is 69 by 4, because here is 4 job. So 17.25. Average job lateness, you are see the late 3 plus 1 plus 7 divided by 4, 2.75. So you understand due date method, you have to find out. The first come, first serve method. In this problem, they are not mentioned which job came first. So you just, for your knowledge, you just record this first come. And longest process time method, you have to, which process is longer, you have to schedule 10, 7, 6, 5. Accordingly, you have to arrange the process time X, Y, Z. Total completion date is 28 days. Average completion date 78 by 4. So 9.5. So average lateness is 5.25. How you will find out? You can make this table, because 10 and your flow time is 10. And next job after 10 plus 7 days, after 17 days completed and 23 days completed, because 17 plus 6, 23 plus 5, after 20 days it will be complete. Next process is dynamic slack and remaining process. How you will find out? Assume the number of operation for each job, W equal to 2, X equal to 3, Y is 2, Z is 4. Number of operation for each job. Number of operation means the number of activities which need to be done to make W. And how we will find DS, the delivery date, you know, delivery date is 14. Delivery date is 14. And process time is 10. And number of operation is for W, 2. So 12 minus 5 to a W, in case W is 12 minus 5, is process time is 5 and you assume is 2. So you find out the ratio 3.5. Similarly, X, Y and Z you can find out, and you can get number 2, 7, 4 and 3.5. Accordingly, you have to arrange. Z is number 1. So Z and then 3.5, W, then X and then Y. Accordingly, you got it the sequence, and same process, you have to find out your job lateness and flow time. 10 plus 5, after 5 days, W is completed and X completed 21 days, 7 completed 28 days. So after completing this, you have to make a chart like this. Average completion time, average job lateness. So in MINPRT, you have to make the job average time, average time. What is the average time? Is 5 plus 11 plus 18 plus 28 divided by 4. You can get your average completion, average completion time. Accordingly, LPT, you also make your job readiness and average completion time. Accordingly, DD also you make your average DD. Here you also can find average completion time and average job lateness. So you can get this overall all process, average job lateness. Accordingly, you have to decide that you have to hand over total job at a time with average job lateness, or you have to complete some job and delivery fast. And only single job also laid is not a issue. So accordingly, you have to decide which process you should select for this type of cases. One work center only and several job. Thank you very much for watching my video. If you like it, please subscribe my channel. Have a nice day.